parade of graduates approaches. We salute the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today. Delaware, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Georgia, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Maryland, South Carolina, New Hampshire, Virginia, New York, North Carolina, Rhode Island, Vermont, Kentucky, Tennessee, Ohio, Louisiana, Indiana, Mississippi, Illinois, Alabama, Maine, Missouri, Arkansas, Michigan, Florida, Texas, Iowa, Wisconsin, California, Minnesota, Oregon, Kansas, West Virginia, Nevada, Nebraska, Colorado, North Dakota, South Dakota, Montana, Washington, Idaho, Wyoming, Utah, Oklahoma, New Mexico, Arizona, Alaska, Hawaii, District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, Guam, American Samoa, Northern Mariana Islands, U.S. Virgin Islands. State flags, order, arms. And now, we invite you to join the staff of Recruit Training Command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter Midway Ceremonial Drill Hall and are announced in the following order.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we welcome today's graduating divisions. Thank you. graduating performing unit is Division 941. Division 941 provides the recruit choir, drill team, and band for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions. Right. Face. Section leaders. Fall out and collect outer garments. Divisions. Counter. March. Divisions, halt.
Prepare for review. At a normal interval, dress left, dress. Ready. Dress right, dress. Ready, front, right, face. Parade, rest.
May I have your attention, please? For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand, and we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officers. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill deck. The photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of Recruit Training Command. Thank you. Division commanders, left or right, face. Parade. Rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant Jessica Morales, Recruit Training Command's Master of Ceremonies. I would like to welcome you to today's Pass in Review. Today, you will see 12 divisions comprised of 958 sailors participating in their graduation ceremony and soon join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit position at center deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is the seaman recruit Matthew Whitaker from Cocoa Beach, Florida. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is the State Flags unit on their 8th week of training, the Staff unit on their 9th week of training, and the Triple Threat unit on their 10th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, recruits are placed into divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags that they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from there, right. Division 3, 2, 5. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Austin Martin. Petty Officer First Class Eric Rao. Petty Officer First Class David Garcia. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Colton Fulcher from Cabot, Arkansas. Division 3, 2, 7. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Ryan Horizuela. Petty Officer First Class Dustin Hunter. Petty Officer First Class Eva Simpson. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Braden Nunn from Apache, Oklahoma. Division 3, 2, 8. Commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Thomas Reed. Petty Officer First Class Alvin Kemivore. Petty Officer First Class Ashley Halsey. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Jaden Haga from Chehalis, Washington. Division 3, 2, 9. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Passion Richmond. Petty Officer First Class Bradley Walker. Petty Officer First Class Luis Negron Velez. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Aiden Pimentel from Corpus Christi, Texas. Division 3, 3, 0. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Gunnar Kazel. Petty Officer First Class Randy Smith. Petty Officer First Class Nonito Niebres. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Apprentice Shyla Mani from Tampa, Florida. Division 3, 3, 1. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Edward Andrew. Petty Officer First Class Rafe Smith. Petty Officer Second Class Roxanne Lewis. and their recruit chief petty officer, Airman Nick Sablon from Guyana, Guam. Division 3-3-2. Commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Jerica Johnson. Petty Officer First Class Thomas Jordan. Petty Officer First Class Drew Fernison. And then Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Apprentice Taylor Brown from Marion, Arkansas. Division 3-3-3. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Kyle Jacobson. Petty Officer First Class Rendell Brulofo. Petty Officer Second Class Kevin Leon. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Robert Wolf from Sahorita, Arizona. Division 3-3-4. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Daniel Jeffrey. Petty Officer First Class Portland Stewart. Petty Officer Second Class Bobby Kinchin. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Apprentice Jacob Killian from Grace Lake, Illinois. Division 3-3-5. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Dennis Aiken. Petty Officer First Class Justin Meadors. Petty Officer Second Class Andrew Nickel. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Airman Apprentice Tyron Bolden from Orlando, Florida. Division 3-3-6. Commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Larry Abram. Petty Officer First Class Peter Lugers. Petty Officer Second Class Eric Velez. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Airman Apprentice Jacob Reeves from Carrier Mills, Illinois. Division 9-4-1. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Dane Moulton. Petty Officer First Class Jordan Mock. Petty Officer Second Class Anthony Thomas. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Apprentice Laney Brown from Monroe, Ohio. On behalf of the commanding officer and staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these division commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. In a moment, you will see the ceremonial side boys, bosun and honor guard, take their places for arrival honors. This time-honored tradition is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the arrival honors, marching on of the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show these sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Thank you. Divisions, attention!
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party? Recruit Training Command, arriving. Navy Recruiting Command, arriving.
Order! Arms!
The guests may be seated.
Right.
Color Guard, parade the colors!
Will the guests please rise? Present arms.
Order! Arms! Retire the colors!
Present arms! Order, arms. Chaplain Nozawa will offer this morning's invocation.
Let us pray. Gracious God, what a wonderful day that we can gather together to celebrate the accomplishment of the Navy's finest sailors who just completed 10 weeks of Navy boot camp. There have been some challenges along the way, physically, mentally, and spiritually going through rigorous training. These men and women are standing here today with honor, courage, and commitment, and we thank you, God. There's been much effort put in for all of us to be here. Recruit Division commanders worked hard to train the recruits, shaping the future of the Navy. All the staff and instructors poured their knowledge and skills into these sailors so we can continue to be an agile force. Without steadfast support of families near and far, these sailors would not be standing here today. It truly has been a team effort, which is what we believe as the United States Navy. Graduation only means the another beginning of a new chapter onto the next stage. May you continue to be with each one of us here so we can continue to serve our country with a sense of mission. And may this graduation ceremony be pleasing to your eyes. Amen.
Father, strong.
Our guests may be seated. At this point, the commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Then, the unit commanders would face about and relay the information to their divisions. Today's events show how orders are passed through the chain of command.
Divisions, report!
It's 65 offensive attack force, sir!
Very well.
It's 37 offensive attack force, sir!
Very well. Very well.
3329 offensive attack force, sir.
Very well.
This is 330 offensive attack force, sir.
Very well.
3331 offensive attack force, sir.
Very well.
This is 332 offensive attack force, sir.
Very well.
This is 333 offensive attack force, sir.
Very well.
This is 334 offensive attack force, sir.
Very well.
This is 335 offensive attack force, sir.
Very well. Very well.
Division 941 offensive attack force, sir.
Very well. All divisions, Pesor count force, sir.
Very well. The Sailor's Creed. Aye.
Morning, Captain. I present the graduating divisions. Request permission to commence the review.
Very well. Commence the review.
Aye, sir.
Parade! Rest!
Sound off!
Thank you. Thank you.
orders reporting, sir.
Very well. Good morning, I'm Captain Kirkwood Brooks, Commanding Officer, Recruit Training Command. I'm pleased to welcome families and friends to our graduation ceremony and look forward to sharing this momentous occasion with you. With us today is our reviewing officer, Rear Admiral Lex Walker, Commander, Naval Recruiting Command. I cannot thank all of our visitors enough for your continued support, and I'm sure your sailors are grateful for your encouragement throughout their training. I would also like to welcome all of the veterans in our audience and thank them for their service to our country. Would all of our veterans please stand and let's give them a round of applause. Division 941 graduates today. They are the triple threat unit providing recruit choir, drill team, and band. Please join me in giving them and the 11 other graduating divisions here today a round of applause for their outstanding performances. This is where our Navy heritage meets the future and where these young men and women enter the profession of arms. The staff of Recruit Training Command is dedicated to providing the United States Navy with basically trained, physically fit, and smartly disciplined sailors, such as those standing here this morning. These sailors have successfully completed 10 weeks of demanding recruit training. They have earned the right to wear the uniform recognized throughout the world as a symbol of freedom. They and others like them serve as the bedrock of our naval forces, and they will join other sailors around the world to give our Navy its combat edge and enable us to help keep this nation secure. This training group is ready to graduate and serve in the world's most powerful Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 958 of the newest and sharpest sailors in the United States Navy.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Recruit Training Command's competitive system among individual recruits and divisions promotes teamwork, attention to detail, and pride in accomplishment. Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in the five mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, applications, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of their division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors, individually and as teams, met performance standards in one or more mission areas. A division that excels in every phase of training qualifies for the Battle Efficiency Honor Division recognition and is awarded the Battle E Honor Flag for this exemplary achievement. Division 3-5 has earned this honor today, and we congratulate them on a job exceptionally well done.
Parade! Rest!
Rear Admiral Walker will now present this week's individual awards, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Brooks. For achieving the highest overall academic score during recruit training, Seaman Apprentice Caroline Nelson, Division 331 from Cleveland, Ohio, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Lake Defiance Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of the American Revolution. Seaman Apprentice Nelson receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor.
Good morning.
for having displayed extraordinary qualities best expressing the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty. Seaman Christian Kiefer, Division 331, from St. Louis, Missouri, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Kiefer is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Airman Elias Moreno, Division 333, from Mission, Texas, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit of intent of the word shipmate. Airman Moreno is given a commemorative plaque for the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor! Seaman Mike Wynn, Division 328, from Shoreline, Washington, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World Wars Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Seaman Wynn is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor! The Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Seaman Apprentice Aiden Branko, Division 333, from Lakeville, Massachusetts, for demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism. Seaman Apprentice Branko is awarded a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Seaman Braden Nunn, Division 327, from Apache, Oklahoma, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places him at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. He is awarded a flag letter of commendation. Seaman Nunn, the staff of Recruit Training Command salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor!
Divisions, attention!
It is appropriate to recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
Hit.
I have the distinct pleasure this morning of introducing our reviewing officer, Rear Admiral Lex Walker, Commander of Navy Recruiting Command. A native of New York, he commissioned in 1994. During his illustrious career, he served at sea as engineer officer aboard USS Cole and USS Leyte Gulf, executive officer of USS Buckley, commanding officer of USS Stockdale, and as Commodore of Destroyer Squadron 7. Rear Admiral Walker's short tours include Deputy for Congressional Affairs at U.S. European Command, Senior Military Assistant to the Secretary of the Navy, and as Deputy Chief of Legislative Affairs at the Navy Office of Legislative Affairs. Prior to his current duties, he served as Commanding Officer, Surface Warfare Skills Command. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm Recruit Training Command welcome to Rear Admiral Walker.
Good morning, and thank you for that introduction. I'm humbled to stand here before you today. Welcome to this wonderful and important event. Welcome to families, friends, distinguished guests, and most importantly, our sailors both old and new. It is a great privilege to be here today as we welcome our newest sailors into the world's finest Navy. As the commanding of Navy Recruiting Command, I know firsthand the hard work and long hours that went into recruiting each and every one of these sailors. I also know the hard work that they did to prepare for and then tackle the challenges of Recruit Training Command. And it is my honor to watch these efforts come to fruition as they graduate and begin the careers that attracted them to the Navy and ultimately place them here before you today. I'd like to recognize all of the family and friends assembled here and those watching online. None of us who have served or who are currently serving could have done so without your love, encouragement, and support. You played a critically important role influencing and shaping your sailor into the fine American standing before you here today. This role will continue as they progress through their Navy career, and I thank you for your love, understanding, and dedication into the future. These new sailors also couldn't have made it this far without the incredible staff here at Recruit Training Command. These hand-selected sailors work extremely hard to transform recruits into the elite sailors you see here today. They are truly forged by the sea. To the Navy's newest who stand here before us, first and foremost, I want to say congratulations and thank you. I know that you had many options available, and you chose to enlist in our Navy, which is made even better today because you are joining our ranks. The demands of leaving home and completing Recruit Training Command have challenged you mentally, physically, and emotionally. This ultra-realistic training is designed to mimic the challenges you will face in the fleet and ensure you are prepared to successfully conquer every challenge that comes your way. You have repeatedly proven yourselves worthy of donning the uniform that identifies you as a member of the United States Navy. You answered the call to serve your country and have dedicated your talent and ability to a cause greater than any one of us. Today we celebrate you, not only for what you've accomplished over the past several weeks, but also for what you will accomplish in your career. You are truly embarking on a wonderful journey. I see the world at your fingertips, just like it had been for me at the beginning of my career over 30 years ago. Never forget this moment, where you came from and who helped you get here. Share your experiences with your friends and family, encourage them to be active participants in your journey, and continue to make them just as much a part of your future as they were a part of the road that led here. You've chosen to serve our country at a time when it is most needed, when America must have a strong naval presence around the world. By graduating today, you are taking on the responsibility of defending our nation as part of the finest Navy in the world, the United States Navy. Always be proud to call yourself a United States Navy sailor. You have earned not only my respect, but the respect of all Americans everywhere. Let me be the first to say, welcome aboard, shipmates.
Thank you.
now receive the salute of the graduating divisions, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Brooks. Please remain seated until your graduates have been placed on Liberty. Please join me in one more round of appreciation for our wonderful musicians of Navy Band Great Lakes. Flags. Posts. Section leaders, fall out and retrieve outer garments. Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy days. And without further delay, now hear this. Liberty call, liberty call.